Good morning, boys and girls. This is Miss Lena. I work at the Adventure Preschool, and I'm so happy to have the chance this morning to read to you from the Jesus Storybook Bible. So I hope you enjoy this message. This morning, we're going to talk about a special wee little man. And if you're visual, I brought a wee little man for you to see. And so can you guess what his name is? Oops, he fell. Oh, no. Can you guess what his name is? All right, well, you're about to find out. So here's the story. The man who didn't have any friends, absolutely none. The story of Zacchaeus from Luke 19. Here we go. There once was a man who didn't have any friends, absolutely none. Do you have friends? I know I have some friends. Well, of course you do, but not Zacchaeus. Poor Zacchaeus didn't have any. You're probably wondering why. Was it because he was so short? That's not a reason to not like someone. Was it because he had a name that was hard to say? Say it with me. Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus. Well, neither is that. Even though he was short and he did have a funny name, that wasn't it. No. People didn't like Zacchaeus because, dun dun dun, he stole their money. What? Oh no. Zacchaeus was a tax collector. He collected taxes. Taxes were what people had to pay the king. But Zacchaeus took more than he was supposed to and kept the extra money for himself and made himself rich. Everyone knew what he was up to, and it made them cross and grumpy. You think you would be grumpy if somebody took all your stuff away? You're probably sure I would. They didn't like Zacchaeus one bit. So they made sure he knew it, doing things like avoiding him and walking on the opposite side of the street and pretending not to see him and whispering things like, there's that nobody who thinks he's somebody, loud enough so he could hear it. Anyway, one day, a huge crowd gathered by the road. Jesus was coming to their town and everyone wanted to see him. Zacchaeus wanted to see Jesus too, but everyone was too tall. Have you ever had that problem? I have that problem in my family. I'm the shortest. And sometimes I'm standing and I'm jumping up and down trying to see around them and they're blocking me. And sometimes, you know what? They even use my head as a handrest. Oh, it's frustrating. Okay, so he tried jumping up and down, but that didn't work. He still couldn't see a thing. Luckily, Zacchaeus had a good idea. I'll climb that sycamore tree, he said. So he did, which is very surprising that he's a good climber since he was such an unusually short man that he had to take a flying leap just to get into his chair in the morning. Oh my goodness. Uh-oh, here we go. Imagine that, standing way up here, way up high, just so that you could see Jesus. It was worth it. From the tree, Zacchaeus had the perfect view all the way down the road. Another minute and suddenly, Jesus was at the tree. He stopped and he looked up. Zacchaeus saw Jesus and Jesus saw Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus, Jesus said, I'd like to come over to your house. Well, Zacchaeus almost fell out of the tree. Come over to my house? Who's he talking to? What? Oh my goodness, he couldn't believe it. No one ever wanted to come anywhere near his house, let alone inside of it. The people saw this, and needless to say, it made them even crosser and grumpier than usual. They mumbled and murmured and muttered. They were talking bad. Why is Jesus being kind to that big sinner? Doesn't Jesus know about him? Zacchaeus scrambled down and took Jesus to his house. He was in a big hurry because he didn't want Jesus to change his mind. I don't think I would either. Perhaps Jesus hadn't heard about him. Perhaps Jesus didn't know about how he had been stealing and how no one liked him and how he didn't have any friends. But Jesus knew. He knew all about Zacchaeus and the stealing and everything. And he still loved him. Zacchaeus was ashamed. "Lord," he said, turning pale, "what I have done was wrong. But now I want to do the right thing. I will give the money back to everyone. Four times what I stole." Four times what he stole. And that's just what he did. Jesus smiled. "My friend," he said, "today God has rescued you." Jesus loved Zacchaeus when nobody else did. He was Zacchaeus' friend, even when no one else was, because Jesus was showing people what God's love was like. His wonderful, never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love. Boys and girls, I want to point something out to you real quick. We're going to go back a little ways in the story where it says, but Jesus knew what Zacchaeus had done and he still loved him. A lot of people miss this little part right here because they think, well, Zacchaeus, sure, Jesus was happy because Zacchaeus gave back the money four times. Can you imagine how many Twizzlers that is? Oh my goodness, I would just be in Twizzler heaven. But that is not why Jesus loved Zacchaeus and why Jesus was happy. Jesus was happy because Zacchaeus had known what he had done wrong and he admitted that he had done wrong. That was the biggest part of all of this. Now, we have a thing called response. And in response to Zacchaeus allowing Jesus to come into his life, he wanted everybody else to feel the same way. So that's why he gave all the money back plus more. See, boys and girls, I like to call this little scenario right here, if you want to relate it to today's time and pick a familiar movie, The Grinch Effect. Remember the movie The Grinch? Yeah, and the two later versions, the Grinch has one person show him lots of love and lots of care and makes him feel like he is worth it no matter what he has done in the past. And because of that, his heart grows so big that he wants to share that with everyone else. And that's exactly what Scripture says happens. So maybe you're that one friend that you can go up to somebody who doesn't seem to be very nice, who doesn't seem to have any friends, who seems to always make mistakes. Maybe you're that one friend who can be like Jesus and share his love with them so that they too can know how wonderful and fearfully they're made, how much Jesus believes in them and loves them no matter what. So boys and girls, I hope this morning what you take from our story of Zacchaeus is it doesn't matter what has happened in the past. If you say you're sorry and you change and you allow Jesus to move in your heart, you will want to share that with everyone and you will want everyone to know, and it will just make Jesus happy. So thank you for listening to me today. Let us close with a prayer. Here we go. Dear God, thank you so much for Jesus. Thank you so much for all that you have blessed us with. And thank you for the chance to say we're sorry and make things new and do things right. And thank you also that if we know someone that needs you in their life, that we're able to go with them and share with them your love so that they too can know how much you love them and how precious they are. We pray all these things in your son Jesus' name. Amen. Now, before I leave, I have one more special little treat. It's my singing debut. So we're going to sing a little song as my daughter rolls her eyes. So here we go. Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. He climbed up on a sycamore tree for the Lord he wanted to see. And as the Savior passed him by, he looked up in that tree and he said, Zacchaeus, you get down from there, for I'm going to your house today. For I'm going to your house today. Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a happy little man was he, for he had seen the Lord that day, and a happy little man was he, a very happy man was he. Yay!